Good morning, everyone. Where are you joining in from? Good morning, Fort Mitchell, Alabama. Good morning. Good morning. Where are you joining in from? New Haven, Connecticut. Good morning. God bless you. Good morning, Michigan. Good morning, Tampa, Florida. Good morning, Aberdeen, Mississippi. God bless you. Good morning. We see you. Good morning, Houston. I love you, precious. Good morning, Houston. Love you all. Good morning, Michigan, Spartanburg, South Carolina. Good morning, Harvest, Alabama. Good morning, Ontario, California. I see you. Good morning, Hollywood, Florida. Good morning. God bless you. Good morning, precious Philadelphia. Good morning. Thank you for joining in with us. Brunswick, Georgia. God bless you. Good morning. We thank God for you. Don't forget to share. Don't forget to share. Don't forget to share. Good morning. Good morning. Where are you joining in from? Good morning, Florida. That's right. It's in the house. Good morning, Grove Town, Georgia. God bless you. I love you. Don't forget to share. Don't forget to invite. Good morning, West Palm Beach, Florida. God bless you. Good morning, Phoenix. God bless you. Thank you for joining in with us this morning. DeSoto, Texas. We see you. Dallas. God bless you. Dominica, God bless you. Stockton, California, thank God. Good morning. Baton Rouge, Sherry, I see you, girl. Baton Rouge, Louisiana, good morning. Where are you joining in from? From Kent, Washington, thank you for joining us. Don't forget to share. Don't forget to invite. New York, we see you. Good morning. Houston, Texas, God bless you. Good morning. Dallas, Texas, God bless you. Surprise, Arizona, God bless you. God bless you. Tallahassee, we see you. We see you. Good morning. Good morning. Yes. Clarksville, Tennessee, God bless you. God bless you. Thank you for joining in. Amen, yes. Pembroke Pines, Florida. Amen. God bless you. Savannah, Georgia. God bless you. God bless you. Fayetteville, North Carolina. Thank you for joining us. Dayton, Ohio. God bless you. Brooklyn, New York. We see you. Arkansas. Thank you for joining us this morning. Indianapolis. We love you. Thank you for joining us. Long Island, New York. God bless you. Don't forget to share. Don't forget to invite. Brent, Alabama, God bless you. God bless you. That's right, the Ravens are coming. Oh, yes. Stockton, California, God bless you. We thank God for you. Yes. He's heaven heard. Yes. Where are you joining in from? Have you checked in? You got to check in. You got to check in. What city, what state? Brent, Alabama, yes, we are family. Amen, and we're joining all together all around the world. Yes, we are. Deerfield Beach, Florida, God bless you. Shalom to you as well. Maryland, thank God for you. West Palm Beach, Florida, we see you. We see you, yes, we do. We see you, yes, we do. Glory to God. Austin, Texas, St. Peter's, Florida, God bless you. Miami, Florida, thank you for joining in with us. Phoenix, Arizona, God bless you. Amen. We are family. Yes, we are. Arkansas, God bless you. Thank you for joining in this morning with us. Yes, Michigan. Yes. all around the world. We connect all around the world. I mean, literally around the world. We have Trinidad. We have China. We have London. Glory to God. We have Africa. And we have all the states just about in America. Lagos. Nigeria just checked in. Good morning. Amen. All around the world. Yes. This is the will of God. Sarasota, Florida. God bless you. The Windy City have just checked in. Chicago, Illinois. God bless you. I'm excited for today, too. God bless you, daughter. Amen. Good morning. Yes. Fort Lauderdale, God bless you. Thank you for joining us today. Yes. Checking in from Georgia. God bless you. Thank you for joining. Tanzania, Africa. God bless you. God bless you. We welcome you. Don't forget to, amen, don't forget to invite, don't forget to share. Buffalo, New York, we see you. We see you. Yes, we do. Is heaven home? Oh, you me. Yes, Lord. Florida, we need to get together to host the woman of God. Oh, sounds great. Michigan, God bless you. It's freezing up. Okay, you all let me know because I see where it stopped. So you all keep me abreast. Good morning, Carson, California. You all let me know because if we need to shut down quickly, we need to do that because people are joining in. Good morning, North Carolina. God bless you. Thank you for joining in with us. You all let me know if it's freezing. Yes. Portage, Indiana. God bless you, precious. We good? Okay, it's good on your end? Okay, you all... No, you're good. Okay. All right, perfect. Okay. You all make sure you keep me abreast. No need to shut down. Okay. All right. Broadcast is good. Got you. Amen. Okay, good. It's good. Colorado checking in. Good morning. Good morning. Where are you checking in from? If you already checked in, then you're good to go. But if you haven't checked in, we need you to check in. Amen. Okay, it's clear. Thank you, daughter. You're good. Good. Not freezing? Good. All right. All right. All right. All right. Come on, we got 60 more seconds. We got 60 more seconds and we're going in. Yes. The Ravens are coming. Woo, I feel the power of God already. It's clear. Amen. Thank you, son. I see you. Westchester, New York. God bless you. Shirts, Texas. God bless you. Sunshine State is here. All right. All right. Amen. If you have not checked in, you know you got to check in. What city, what state? But if you checked in, you good to go. Toronto, Canada, because why? We join in all around the world. Yes, we do. Columbia, South Carolina, I see you. I see you. Yes, I do. I see you. Detroit, Michigan, I see you. Yes, Dallas, Texas, I see you. Come on here. Scotland, Aberdeen, I see you. Detroit, Michigan, I see you. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Florida, good morning. We see you. Oh, he showed you this last night. Somebody better praise God. My daughter said God showed her this word last night. We on point. Sunrise, Florida, I saw you. Trinidad, God bless you. Aberdeen, Mississippi, God bless you. We're going in, we're going in, we're going in. Savannah, Illinois, God bless you. We thank you for joining in with us this morning. When I say to you that I see you, that's God saying, I see you. I see your circumstance. I see your situation. So when I call your city and your state out and I say, I see you, it's not literally just me saying, I see you. It is the Lord. I see you, Dallas, Texas. That is God saying, I see you. I know what you're going through. I know what you're facing, but I got the answer, said the Lord. Not only do he have the answer, he's going to move on your behalf. Huh? West Palm Beach, Florida, we see you. Bronx, New York, we see you. Houston, Texas, thank you for joining in with us. Minneapolis, Minnesota, we see you. Yes, Long Island, New York, we see you. Oh, yes, oh, yes, oh, yes, oh, yes, oh, yes. Oh, yes, we see you. Excited for this word, yes. Atlanta, Georgia, we see you. Thank you, daughter Larissa. Memphis, I see you. I see you, girl. Nuriston, Pennsylvania, I see you. Jackson, Mississippi, God bless you. Here we go. Here we go in 20 seconds. In 20 seconds, we're going in. We're going in. God bless you. Troy, Michigan, I see you. We're going in. The Ravens are coming. The Ravens are coming. What you say, Apostle? My God, from Zion. Come on, Jesus. Nashville, Tennessee, I see you. Greenville, South Carolina, we see you. Union City, Georgia, God bless you. Yes, Michigan, we got you. We got you, Michigan. We see you. Brooklyn, New York, God bless you. Thank you for joining in. We're going in. Here we go. You need to be free. For the Spirit of the Lord shall break you free from all bondages. Yes, he will. Dallas, Texas, we see you. Michigan, we see you. Thank you for joining in with us. Austin, Texas, we see you. Good morning. Lawrenceville, Georgia, thank you for checking in, joining in with us. The Ravens are coming. Yes, they are. Dallas, Texas, God bless you. The Ravens. The Ravens are coming. Yes, they are. Yes, Rochester, New York, thank you for joining in with us. We see you, Chandler, Arizona. We're going in 10 seconds, 10 seconds. North Carolina, we see you. Charlotte, North Carolina. Michigan. Yetakoboshianda. Tennessee, we see you. Yes. Yepashikodoboshaya. This is confirmation. Listen, I'm shouting already. I don't know if y'all gonna have a teacher because just about people are saying God been talking to them. God gave them dreams. God been having them to speak it. I need a greeter. I need a greeter. I need a greeter. I need a greeter. Davenport, Florida. Good morning. 5 seconds. We going in. 5 seconds. We going in. Yes, divine, divine provision. That's right. He woke you up to get on here. God is good. Look at God. Look at God. Webster, what is that? Massachusetts? This is the third. Oh, my God. From Zion, West Palm Beach. Oh, my God. Good morning. Confirming. Apostle Erling Miles. Thank you for that. My God, from Zion. You want a cap? Amen. If you want a cap, message me. Message me. It's still frozen, precious. Priscilla McIntosham. Shut it down and then bring it back up. How do you get one? Just message me. If you want a cap, just message me. If you're freezing, somebody let me know. I got one person said they're frozen. If you are frozen, if you're the only one and everybody is good to go, then you shut yours down, reboot it, and bring it back up. Yes, we are all around the world. You're not usually up at this time, but he woke you up. My God, from Zion, y'all gonna make me fall out on this side. Y'all gonna make me fall out on this side with excitement, with joy. Oh my God. My Lord, Father, in the name of Jesus, those that have been having dreams and waking up and the enemy is trying to steal their dreams, I come against that spirit right now, the dream catcher, the dream stealer. Glory to God. In the name of Jesus, we command you to be able to remember what you see in the midnight hour in Jesus' name. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Well, praise the Lord, everybody. We thank God for you, 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 and you. Glory to God. This is, amen, our weather forecast channel, and we are all around the world. Yes, we are. And for that reason, we need to praise God. Why? Because the gospel is going all around the world, and you and I are making it happen on today. And so I am your weather forecast announcer on today, and we have, amen, in the weather forecast spirit, guess what it's calling for? It's not calling for rain. Watch this. It's not calling for a storm, but it is calling for the ravens are coming. Yes, the ravens are coming. I need you to type that down there. The ravens are coming. I need all of us to be on the same page. We have already got, amen, confirmation. We already got affirmation, amen, that God has been speaking it to his people. Glory to God, that the ravens are coming. Glory to God. I want you to type that, amen, on the screen. The ravens are coming. They're coming to your house. They're coming. Oh, yes, they are. Glory to God. I feel the presence of God. I feel the power of God. The ravens are coming. Yes, they are. Glory to God. Hallelujah. We know before we pray on the Weather Forecast channel, we begin to receive the word of God because we stand up on the word and we give God back his word. Everybody know what I say every Wednesday morning. God watches over his word to perform his word. Watch this. He doesn't watch over us. He watches over his word. So if his word is lodged in your spirit, then he's watching over that word that's lodged in your spirit. And as you and I begin to speak it forth, he begins to perform it. I need somebody to realize that on this morning, glory to God, that God is going to perform what he said in his word. Everybody that is on here, you need to start praising God. You now, if you at work, now don't act up. I don't want you to get fired, okay? But if you at home, you in your car, you need to start praising God. You in your front room, you need to start praising God. I've already got confirmation, glory to God, that God been talking to his people, that God has gave some people dreams on last night about what God is about to say. We are on schedule. We are on point. My God, from Zion, you all may not have no teacher today. I feel the power of God. This surge of the power of God is surging. Came a shanda, which means people are pulling on the oil of the anointing that rests upon my life. I'm so happy that you're pulling. It doesn't make no sense for us to carry the oil, glory to God, and no one pulls on the oil that is upon one's life. So I'm so happy that you are pulling, because the more you pull, the more you anticipate for God, the more you look for God, the more you expect God, the more he downloads and he begins to pour into our spirit. Glory to God. So we know on the Weather Forecast channel, we don't just, amen, start praying. If that's what God gives you, you do what God has given you to do. But on the Weather Forecast channel, we begin to hear what thus said the Lord from the scriptures, and then we pray back the word. We realize that whatever's in the word, God has to, my God, perform it. God said, glory to God, he watched over his word. His word does not return back to him void, but where he has sent it, it shall accomplish where he sent it. Look at your neighbor, tell your neighbor, and if you are your neighbor, tell your neighbor, God sent the word to our house. And if God sent the word to our house, come on, Zacchaeus, and talk to us. Glory to God. If God sent the word to our house, then guess what? He's going to perform the word that he sent into our house. What I need from you is your spirit to open up to the will of God, your spirit to open up to what God is saying. I need you to walk into expectancy right now. I need you to know that God is speaking to you. There are some people on here say, I usually don't wake up at this time, but he told me to get up and turn on the Weather Forecast channel. Come on, somebody. God is blowing my mind already, and we haven't even went into the word of God. And so what does the weather forecast, my God, is calling for today? The ravens are coming. Yes, they are. The ravens are coming. I see you, China. China just checked in. Glory to God. The ravens are coming. My God, from Zibashanda, Hopakiko, Shanda Rabosaya. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, by the working power of the Holy Spirit, Lord, we are attentive to your word. We have yielded ourselves this morning to you. God, speak, Rabosaya, and we are hearing what you're saying. We thank you, Lord God, that we shall have great testimonies and praise reports behind this. Father, we thank you. Glory to God, Rabosaya. We praise you in advance. We bind the hand of Satan. We come against every foul and every corrupt spirit now, and we cast it out. We come against any interruptions in the name of Jesus. We thank you, Lord God, that this word shall have free course in our lives, in our spirit. God, we thank you for every person that is on this line on today, on this channel on today. God, do a miraculous, glory to God, blessing, a miraculous miracle, a miraculous door to open for them. Father, we thank you that the ravens are coming. In Jesus' name, I decree and declare it to be so. Well, here we go. It's found in the book of 1 Kings. Glory to God. It's found in the book of 1 Kings chapter 17 is where we're going. 1 Kings chapter 17. 1 Kings chapter 17. That's right. Keep on. If you just got on, don't forget to check in. If you just got on, don't forget to check in. Amen. 1 Kings chapter 17 is where we're going, beloved. And it's found in verse 2 through 6. The Bible decrees the word of God to be so. And the word of the Lord came unto him, saying, watch what God is saying, get thee hence and turn thee eastward and hide thyself by the brook Cherith, that is before Jordan. And it shall be that thou shalt drink of the brook. And I have commanded the ravens to feed thee there. So he went and did according to the word of the Lord, for he went and dwelt by the brook Cherith, that is before Jordan. Are you hearing me? Everybody go to 1 Corinthians chapter 1. 1 Corinthians chapter 1. 1 Corinthians chapter 1. 1 Corinthians, I feel the power of God. Oh my God. 1 Corinthians chapter 1 and round about verse 27 is where we're going to land at on today. That's 1 Corinthians chapter 1 and verse 27, for those that are writing it down on the screen. We are going to 1 Corinthians, 1 Corinthians chapter 1, verse 27. 1 Corinthians chapter 1, verse 27, the Bible decrees the word of God to be so. But God had chosen the foolish things of the world to confound the wise, and God had chosen the weak things of the world to confound the things which are mighty. Let me read that again. But God had chosen the foolish things. He's chosen the foolish things. God has chosen the foolish things. It's foolish, glory to God, for God to say he's going to send ravens. Are you hearing me? Ravens in this season, in this time, and in this hour of our lives, glory to God, to provide for us. That is foolish. Are you hearing me? God is getting ready to do something that is so foolish into man's eyesight, glory to God, that all we can say it is God that did this very thing. So here it is again. But God had chosen the foolish things. He chosen this. This is the way he chosen today for you, and you, and myself. This is what God chosen. But God had chosen the foolish things of the world to confound, to confuse people. Are you hearing me? Glory to God. The wise, confuse the wise, those that think they know everything, those that think they know which way God is coming, those that think they know how God is going to do it. Boo, we can't lock God in. Are you hearing me? God would have done it one way, this way, and when we look in this way, here come that way. Are you hearing me? In other words, God said, tell the people, glory to God, to be open to me. Tell them, don't lock me in to how I blessed them yesterday. Tell them, don't lock me in on how I opened that door for them yesterday. Just know I'm going to open up the door. Just know I'm going to bless them. Tell them, don't lock me in. Glory to God. That I both see. He said, amen. Just lift your hands and say, God, God, do whatever it is you want to do, how you want to do it. All I know, God said he's going to bless you. All I know, God said he's going to heal you. All I know, God said he's going to deliver and make a way out of no way. It is up to God how he does it. Are you hearing me? Do not block him in. Do not lock him in. Don't put him in a box. Are you hearing me? He's getting ready to confound, to confuse the wise ones. Are you hearing me? How can you get this and you ain't got no money? How, glory to God, how can you get this promotion and you ain't even got the education? You ain't even got the experience behind you. Glory to God. How can you throw your cane away? How can you throw the wheelchair away? Glory to God, when you had that all your life to take you from here and there, because God getting ready to confound. He's getting ready to confuse. How is it when man said they had no cure? When man said they couldn't do nothing else for you? Glory to God, all of a sudden your body is healed. Glory to God, and you got your strength back. Glory to God. When you had, my God, from Zion, they gave you a foreclosed letter. Somebody I'm talking to right now, they gave you a foreclosed letter. Glory to God. And yet and still, watch this. My God, it turned in your favor. My God, they should have been coming to put you out of the house. But my God, from Zion, they brought another letter and said, glory to God, everything is paid. Everything is turned around. Everything is zero. Glory to God. In other words, you're going to start afresh and anew. The ravens are coming, precious. I'm trying to tell somebody the ravens are coming. And I'm so happy that the ravens are coming. Tell your neighbor, and I told you, if you ain't got no neighbors, learn how to speak to yourself and say, the ravens are coming. Glory to God. Don't get so, amen, big-headed. Don't get so spiritual. You know how we do. Sometimes we can overdo stuff. You know how it is, because we're supposed to be spiritual, but sometimes we overdo it. And God don't want us to overdo it. He's going to send some dirty birds. Are you hearing me? In other words, I should have put it like that. The dirty birds are coming. That's what I should have put on that. The dirty birds are coming. The ones that cuss. The ones, glory to God, that don't call on the name of Jesus. Glory to God. Those, amen, don't have no respect. Are you hearing me? But they're going to be the ones that's going to bless us. They're going to be the ones that's going to do what God has told them to do. As a matter of fact, I'm already in the text. Glory to God. He said, I'm going to command them. Are you hearing me? So don't get so deep. And you said the devil is a liar. God said, I'm going to send a dirty bird. I'm going to send a raven to bless you. I'm getting ready to confound the wise. I'm getting ready to confuse those that think they know what I'm about to do for you. Those that think they know they got me locked in. God said, not so. I'm getting ready to do something that's going to be so foolish. Are you hearing me? So foolish to men that think they're wise. I'm getting ready, glory to God, to cause a dirty bird. Did you hear me? A dirty bird. Yes, ravens are dirty birds. Are you hearing me? Glory to God from Zion. They are coming, and God is commanding them to come. Is anybody listening? Did everybody go home? Glory to God from Zion. Yes, Lord. Ravens are large black birds, closely related to the crows, which mean ravens are not crows, but they kind of similar look. They similar look like each other, but they're not. Ravens are scavengers. They are scavengers, which mean they eat dead animals. They eat carcasses. Are you hearing me? They're dirty birds. And so you need to understand, God said, I'm getting ready to use a dirty bird, an unclean person. Are you hearing me? I'm getting ready to use people. Glory to God. Just get ready to bless my people, said God. I'm getting ready to command them. You just tapped into a journey and a season and a time of your life that God is saying, I'm getting ready to use that boss. Are you hearing me? Glory to God. Yes, they may not like you. Yes, they may try to, amen, get in your way and hinder you. But God said, I'm going to use a dirty bird. Are you hearing? I'm not going to use somebody that both side that speak in tongues. I'm not going to use somebody. Y'all not hearing me. I'm not going to use somebody right at this particular point of your life. I'm not going to use somebody that quotes scriptures. I'm not going to use somebody that prays and worship me, said God. He said, I'm going to use a dirty bird. I'm going to use an unclean bird. Not just bird, but birds. Are you hearing me? They are about to come to your aid. Are you hearing me? God said, don't you worry. I don't let nobody pour into your spirit but me, said God. But God said, the dirty birds, the dirty birds, Apex, Shakobo, Saya. It's for your natural being. Are you hearing me? God told you that you're going to drink of the brook. That's spirit right there. God is going to make sure he keep pouring in your spirit. Are you hearing me? He's going to make sure he keep pouring that you get strengthened in your spirit. Are you hearing me? But he commanded the dirty birds. Are you hearing me? He commanded the ravens. Are you hearing me? And you don't have to worry about which way they're coming. You don't have to worry about, well, they coming from the projects. Well, they coming from the streets. Are you hearing me? Well, they, my God, from Zion, they cuss people out. They don't respect. When it come to you, they going to respect you. Why? Because they coming to bless you. They're coming to help you. They're coming to do. Are you hearing me? And not only are they street people, these are people, glory to God, that are Boshiah, that has 400, 500 fortune companies. Is anybody listening, or did everybody go home? These are people, glory to God. Shoko, Baba, I just heard the Holy Ghost. Woo! For those that are trying to get in school, my God from Zion, my God from Zion, the unclean bird does not do things right, but it's going to get you in. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Glory to Kibesh, Shanda, Hadabo, Shanda. I'm trying to tell three people, there's some dirty birds coming, and you better not, amen, turn them away, because they are to bless you. They have been commanded to bless you. You don't have to worry about your spirit, man. I've got to get in this word. God said, I'm going to be the one that's going to pour into your spirit, but the natural man on the outside, that you need in the natural, that you need in the physical. Is anybody listening? God said, I've already commanded, amen, the ravens to feed you, the ravens to take care of you. Well, let me go back over here, because, you know, I just go. Glory to God. And I'm Messiah. I know Nancy Rice. My spirit is so high too. Glory to God. And I'm Messiah. God said, take, first of all, take the limits off. Take the brakes off. Come on. And don't be talking crazy. Don't talk crazy now. Don't talk crazy when the person come. Some folks ain't even going to look like they can be able to help you. Some folks going to look like you got to help them. Are you hearing me? Are you hearing me? Are you hearing me? Glory to God. Are you hearing me? My God from Zion. God said, I am getting ready to use the world. Glory to God, to bless my people, to bless my children. Are you hearing me? Glory to God. They thieves, they robbers. Come on here, somebody. Glory to God. They cut throats. Come on here, somebody. But they're about to help us. Is anybody listening, or did everybody go home? Yes, they are. Come on here, somebody. Woo! Bakashanda. My God from Zion, the ravens are coming. Yes, so here it is. Before we begin to pray, beloved, in chapter 17 of 1 Kings, you have to understand that when we pick it up in verse 2, thank you for the hearts, thank you for the thumbs up, thank you for all that. I love everybody, amen, and I forgot to send hugs and kisses, glory to God, and love all around the world, and I'm sending it right now, hallelujah. I just jumped in because the power of God was on me, glory to God, and it's still on me. Yes, Lord Jesus. Here we go. Here it is in chapter 17 of verse 2. The Bible said, and the word of the Lord came unto him, saying, came unto who? Came unto the prophet, saying, glory to God. Here it is in verse 1. We see where the Lord, amen, spoke through the prophet Elijah at this time, the one that was carrying the word, the one that was speaking the word of God, the one that was encouraging people, the one that was witnessing, glory to God, the one that was warning people. Are you getting this? I'm talking about you. Yes, it was Elijah. Yes, Elijah was a prophet. Glory to God. And there was a word in his mouth. And God said, glory to God, he's given you words to speak. You may not be a prophet, but you can prophesy the word of God. You can encourage people. Are you hearing me? Glory to God. You can begin to lead them to Christ. Are you hearing me? My God from Zion, you encourage people. You pray for people. Are you hearing me? My God from Zion, you help people. My God. So he has said, I put a word in your mouth. He put a word in Elijah's mouth for, and my God, for Ahab. And he said, as long, amen, as I say, watch this. He said, as long as I say, there will not be no rain. The heavens are going to shut up. Are you hearing me? The heavens are going to shut up. Glory to God. And there will not be any rain. Glory to God. Until I say so. This is what the scripture said in verse 1. Here it is. Now, verse 2, after Elijah has prophesied, after he has prophesied, the Bible says God begins to speak to Elijah personally. I'm trying to tell three people, and it's more than three. three people, amen, on this weather forecast channel, that God is saying, I'm talking to you. I am speaking to you. Glory to God. Did you not know there were many other people around at this time? Did you not know there were many other prophets around at this time? Did you not know? It wasn't like God just said, okay, you're the only one. He could have spoke to everybody, but he chose to speak to you. So everyone that has tuned in and everyone that will tune in after we shut down here, God is talking to you. Let me tell you something. Precious, you couldn't have just got on here because you wanted to get on here. Are you hearing me? The Holy Ghost led you on here. Glory to God. Because he's talking to you. He's talking to your house. He's talking to your prayer request. He's talking, amen, to your family. He's talking to your marriage. Are you hearing me? He's talking to your children, though he's talking to you. My God, from Zion, you better look around and you better start prophesying, amen, and you better tell everybody the ravens are coming. God is about to use unclean people or to bless you. He's about to use people, glory to God, that got beer in their mouth, that got vodka in their mouth. Y'all ain't saying nothing to a sister. Glory to God. And I'm going to see that smoke cigarettes. Y'all ain't going to say nothing. You ain't going to like me here, but it's going to be all right. He going to use people that's on drugs, all that type of stuff. Are you hearing me? Because God is saying the wealth of the wicked is laid up for the just. I'm getting ready to cause and command ravens to come to your aid. I'm going to command ravens to come to your aid. As I'm speaking it out of my mouth, it is being happening right now. God is touching people, glory to God, that are unclean. Did you hear me? They are not speaking in tongues. Is anybody listening? Glory to God. They are not praying. Are you hearing me? My God from Zion, God said, I'm going to command some ravens to bless you in this hour. Woo, Peshanda. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. God is so good. If God did not tell us, amen, if God did not tell us what he was doing, glory to God. And my God, those that are unclean, those, amen, that don't have their life together, those that even been playing church, how about that? Uh-huh, they've been unclean. How about that? Uh-huh. Glory to God. If God did not tell us what he was, how he was going to do, because I told you last Wednesday, if you did not look at, amen, the clippings from last Wednesday morning weather forecast, you ought to do it. My God, from Zion, this is how God is going to do it. God said, I'm going to use a raven to bless you. I'm going to use a raven to help you. I'm going to use a raven to open that door. I'm going to use a raven, glory to God, to change it. Are you hearing me? God said, I've already commanded, yes, I've already commanded a raven, not just one, but he said ravens. Are you hearing me? Now watch this. I got to pray. Glory to God. Watch this, beloved. Watch this, beloved. It says it right here. It says, get thee hence and turn thee eastward. In other words, God is saying, I'm getting ready to give you instructions. I'm going to tell you which way to go. I'm going to tell you. He's given instructions and he's given direction. Are you hearing me? He's given instructions and he's given direction. So what am I saying to us? We must be sensitive to the Spirit of God, because he's going to give us instructions and he's going to give us direction. He told Elijah, the prophet, his man, glory to God, the one that speaks on his behalf in the earth. He said, get up from where you are at. In order for me, glory to God, to command the ravens, they're not coming where you at. You must go where I tell you to go. You must do what I'm telling you to do. Glory to God. In other words, I just heard the Holy Ghost, amen, speak Genesis 12 in my spirit and said, come out of your comfort zone. He's going to get you out of your comfort zone. He might just tell you, glory to God, beyond noble sight. He might just tell you, you just tired as can be. I need you to get up and I need you to walk your community. Is anybody listening? Did everybody go home? Here it is. He told the prophet, get up from this right where you at. I need you to get up and then I need you to go eastward. In other words, I'm giving you direction. I'm not just going to tell you to go, but I'm going to tell you where to go. I'm going to tell you which way to go. And God said, get out of the box. God said, get out of your plans. Get out of how you used to do things. He's getting ready to mess up how you used to do things. Because my God, he could tell you to go to a certain store. And you said the store is right there. And if I just go down this street, I'm right there. But God can take you the long way. And you can't sit there and you cannot murmur, complain. Why? Because, amen, the raven has been commanded. It's up to you to get up. The raven is not coming where you are at. You got to get up. The Lord is going to tell you where to go. The Lord is going to tell you who to talk to. The Lord is going to give you specific instructions. You're not going to be just out there. Glory to God. Don't know what to do. Don't know where to go. No, he gave the prophet, my God, he gave him specific instructions. He said, get up from thence and turn thee eastward and hide and hide. And hide, Deba Shanda, and hide by the brook. Are y'all hearing me? Hide thyself by the brook, Sheriff. I need you to hide, Abasi. Hide in me. I need you to hide in me, said the Lord. I need you to hide in me, even though I'm going to use the raven to bless you in the physical realm, in the natural realm. I need you to hide your spirit in me. He said, hide by the Cherith brook. Are you hearing me? Are you hearing me? Well, I looked up the word brook. It is a small stream or a creek. Now, the brook Cherith, Hebrew, that word means carrot. K-E-R-I-T-H. Carrot. That's what it means in Hebrew. It is a cutting. Like when the earthquake comes from underground and it cuts, it causes things to break in half. It splits stuff, okay? So the brook Cherith, glory to God, the brook is a stream, but Cherith, C-H-E-R-I-T-H, in Hebrew is Kerith, K-E-R-I-T-H, which means a cutting, separating, seclusion. Are you hearing me? Conceal yourself. Hide means to keep out of sight. In other words, people are not going to know where you at. People are not going to know what you're doing. Are you hearing me? In other words, the Lord is saying, don't tell nobody what I'm going to tell you to do. Woo! See, right there, I needed a greeter. Don't tell nobody what I'm getting ready to do until it's completed. Until it's done. Are you hearing me? He said, I want you to hide. Hide. I'm telling you where to hide. I told you to go eastward, but then I'm telling you to hide at the brook Cherith, which means conceal, which means separate, which means cutting. That means I'm going to cut some things away from you. I'm going to cut some people away from you. Glory to God. And people are going to be looking. Well, you usually call me at this time. You usually check in with me at this time. But God said, no, at this season and at this time, I need you to hide in me. Are you hearing me? Glory to God. Shanda. Well, Apostle, I don't understand. What you mean you don't understand? God said, I want you to hide in me. Glory to God. I need you to cut away. I need you to get alone. I need you to be separated. This is what happened. Remember now, the prophet was around people and he prophesied. Am I talking? Yes, you are, because you're in the word. Then God came and said, I need you to separate yourself. I need you to hide. I need them not to know where you at in the realm of the spirit. I don't need them to know where you at in the realm of the spirit. Woo! Glory to God. Woo, Pashana. Are you hearing me? My God from Zion. He said, because as you hide in the rim of the spirit, as you hide, amen, by the brook stream, the streams of water, I'm going to keep, amen, the Holy Ghost is going to keep refreshing you. It's going to keep renewing you. It's going to keep restoring you. Are you hearing me? Glory to God. And he said, I need you to conceal. Women of Zion, you are the women makeup. There is a concealer that we wear. Glory to God. Come here, Shia. You got to conceal. Amen. You got to be quiet. Are you hearing me? People are saying, my God, I didn't know that was happening with you. I didn't know. Oh my goodness. I didn't know. They're not going to know until after everything is done. Are you hearing me? Hide in the Lord. Amen. Glory to God. God said, separate. It's time to get alone. Amen. A-L-O-N-E. It's time to separate yourself. Glory to God. Come here, Shana. Is anybody listening? Did everybody go home? It's time to separate yourself. He's telling a man, the prophet, that after he prophesied, glory to God, it's time to separate yourself. And you're not just going to go anywhere. You're going to get by. Hide yourself. Anybody ever heard the game hide and seek? Woo, glory to God, hide and seek. You got a person that's going to be looking for everybody, and then you got the other players that go and hide. They go find themselves a place where can't nobody see them, that the person that's going to come to look for them, they won't be able to see them. So you know the game. The one that's going to come looking, they count backwards, and they count real loud. So that gives the other ones a chance to know where they at. Are you hearing me? And everybody must find a hiding spot or a hiding place. And so the person says 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. I'm coming. You got to be hidden. And just because the person that may be close to you, but they don't see you because you're hiding, you don't come out. You don't let it be known. Are you hearing me? Okay. If somebody is conversating with you, and they are conversating with you, and they almost on point about what God is doing for you, but they didn't hit it. They're around the vicinity of what God said he was going to do. Have you ever heard somebody talking to you and all of a sudden they in the vicinity of what God said to you about what he was going to do for you, but they didn't hit the bullseye? If somebody's in the vicinity, you begin to say, that's God right there, because God said, don't come out of hiding. They could just be around, and it's not nothing bad. It's not nothing crazy. It's just, you know, I'm just showing you something. He said, don't come out of hiding. In other words, you are hiding in me. Don't tell nobody what is happening now. This is a season of your life that God is saying, do not. I need you to be alone. I need you to separate. I need you to cut off. Are you hearing me? And so when that game is going on, and the person that is seeking the other ones, and the other ones that is hidden, even though if I'm standing near the person that is hidden, but I can't see him, that doesn't mean they come out. That just means you close by me, but you don't see me. So I don't come out. I only come out if you see me and you can touch me. Are you hearing me? So God said, do not come out. Even if the persons that are talking to you is near of the conversation that I told you that I was going to do for you, that I told you that I was going to do for your family, that I told you that I was going to do for your marriage, that I told you that I was going to do for your body, that I told you that I was going to do for your finance. My God was like, he said, hide, hide, hide by the shepherd, and let me keep pouring into you, and let me keep restoring you, and let me keep reviving you, and let me keep renewing you. He said, hide. He said, dwell there until I tell you to come out. Woo! Until he tell you to come out. Come out, come out from wherever you are. Until he tell you to come out. In other words, don't you tell nobody until I tell you to tell them. See, I'm good with that. I don't be telling folks stuff. You look up at Vanessa, I already done it. And you be like, how you do that? Because he told me to hide. When he's telling me to hide, woo, glory to God, then I don't say nothing. Are you hearing me? Are you hearing me? So don't come out. Amen. Don't come out. Come on. Come on. Let's go some more. Let's go some more. So he told him where to go, right? He told him the first thing he told him to do is for his spirit to dwell in a certain place. He got his spirit in the right place. He got his spirit in the right posture, okay? Are you hearing me? So God is going to deal with your spirit. God is going to keep on, amen, ministering to your spirit. God is going to keep on, amen, speaking to your spirit. Are you hearing me? The water, but you got to dwell in a hiding place. He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide up under the shadow of the Almighty. He that dwelleth in the secret place, he that dwelleth in the secret place, keep on praying, keep on hiding. Are you hearing me? Keep on hiding. Are you hearing me? Glory to God. He that dwelleth in the secret place of the Most High shall abide up under the shadow of the Almighty. Are you hearing me? Glory to God. Hide in God. Hide in God. Lord, hide me. Lord, hide me. This is what I say to God. I said, God, I need you to hide me and my children. I need you to hide us, oh God. I need you to hide me and my ministry. I need you to hide me and my spiritual sons and daughters. I need you to hide us in you. Are you hearing me? Hide us. Hide us. Open your mouth and talk to God and say, God, hide me. Are you hearing me? And he will hide you. Watch this. We're going on. Glory to God. Hallelujah. He said, now watch what he says. He said, hide thyself by the brook Cherith. That is before Jordan. That is before Jordan. That is before Jordan. That is before Jordan. Well, watch this. That is before Jordan. You got to understand that Jordan, amen, is before Jordan. And Jordan, the part that God said, hide yourself before Jordan, is the opening part of where the water starts. Woo, where the water starts from and it moves. So God said, I'm going to put you in a place where it starts, where everything is starting, because I'm putting you before Jordan. Are you hearing me? If you go into Joshua and you begin to study the scripture, it says that we get ready to cross over Jordan, remember? And it says at that particular time that a certain season, a certain time, that water, the water had rose up. Are you hearing me? And I brought that last week. I believe I brought that last Wednesday, if not two Wednesdays ago. And when God departed it, are you hearing me? As the priests put their feet in the water departed so they can walk over. Okay, so now, before Jordan, there's always a starting and there's always an ending. That's why God said, I know the end from the beginning. There's always a starting point and there's always an ending. And God said, I'm putting you at the mouth of the starting point, the mouth of the starting point of where the water flow. You're going to get fresh river, because out of your belly shall flow rivers of living water. You're going to have fresh living water. Are you hearing me? Nothing is going to be, amen, it's not going to be stagnated. Are you hear me? The water, glory to God, that you're going to receive while the ravens, I ain't even got to them yet. Glory to God, is going to be fresh. It's going to be a refreshener. Are you hearing me? It's going to be a renewer. Are you hearing me? It's going to be a restorer. Are you hearing me? Because you're at the beginning. He said before Jordan. And like I said, prior to what I just said, you could go to, amen, Joshua, and you can see when the Lord told Joshua what to do when it was time to go across Jordan. So, before Jordan is the beginning of the flow. Before Jordan is the beginning of the flow, glory to God, of what the stream is starting. God said, I'm going to start with you, glory to God, where the Spirit of the Lord is going to move freshly in your spirit. I'm going to start with you, glory to God, as I'm moving in the realm of the Spirit, I'm going to reveal to you, said the Lord, what I'm going to be doing in the earth. I'm going to reveal to you what I'm doing in your family. I'm going to reveal to you what I'm doing with your finances. I'm going to reveal to you what I'm doing with your marriage. I'm going to reveal to you. Is anybody listening? Did everybody go home? Because he said, I need to posture your spirit. And your spirit is going to be before Jordan, which is the beginning or the open of where the stream starts. Are you hearing me? Glory to God from Zion. My God, no stagnated water. No unclean water, no poisonous water. It's going to be fresh. It's going to be a refreshener. Are you hearing me? Watch what he says now. He dealt with the spirit man first. Watch what he says. He said, watch this now, about the brook of the Cherit and before Jordan. Verse 4, and it shall be that thou shalt drink of the brook, and it shall be that just keep drinking. What I'm giving you, keep drinking. What I'm going to pour in your spirit, keep drinking. Glory to God, Moshana. He said, keep drinking. Anybody, especially on my brother, amen, and one of my armor bearers, that every time we go out, y'all pray for us, okay? Glory to God. But every time we go out, they always get water. They don't get pop. If they really get pop, it's because they want to burp. But they always get water. Me, the only way I'm going to get some water as I'm eating, if the tea ain't right. If the tea don't taste right, if they don't have tea, then I may scoot over to a Pepsi. But at the end, I drink my hot water and lemon. But I'm saying they always drinking water. Now, if you really thirsty, You drink. You just keep drinking. You keep drinking. God said, because we're going to be thirsty for him, he's going to keep, glory to God, and I'm going to say, causing us to drink, glory to God, from him. Are you hearing me? That's some good stuff right there. Amen. Watch this. Watch this. He said, thou shalt drink of the brook. Don't drink of nothing else. Drink of the brook. I'm going to cause you to drink from me, said the Lord. I'm going to cause you to drink from me, said the Lord. Keep drinking from me. Even though the ravens, the dirty birds, the unclean birds, is going to bless you. I don't want you to drink from them. I just want you to receive what they're going to do for you. But you're not to drink from them. Because we as a human race, we as a people can sometimes, glory to God, whomever God uses to bless, whomever God uses to do something for us, sometimes we turn and we start drinking from them. Whatever they saying to us, God, you hear me? We start drinking from them. Glory to God, that foul life, we start intaking from them. God don't want us to intake from them. He just wants them to bring what it is, drop it out and keep it stepping. And when you need it again, bring it. And are you hearing me? He is telling you not to connect. You're not to sit here, connect and get people phone numbers. You're not to, glory to God, talking about we get ready to go eat some lunch. We get ready to have, and we're going to eat some dinner. No. That is not what it is, because when you start doing it, you're drinking from them. Are you hearing me? God don't want you to drink from them. They're unclean. Glory to God. They're not serving God. Are you hearing me? And yes, beloved, it could be somebody in the church. They just playing church. Are you hearing me? And he could use people in the street. He is saying they're unclean. They're scavengers. They will, watch this, they'll smile in your face and stab you in the back. Are you hearing? Unclean birds. You don't sit there talking about, well, I thank you. Is there anything I could do for you? You know, I know how to cook. You want me to cook for you? No. He said, don't drink from them. Don't drink from them. You keep drinking from me, said the Lord. Are you hearing me? Because some of us, we are so gullible. And when that person has really, my God, really released what it is God said, we tend to say, whoo, we want to grab a hold now. We want to connect now. God said, No. You didn't know them before. And when they drop off the blessing, you still don't know them. Are you hearing me? They're unclean. They're unclean. That's right. Receive the package and keep it moving. Don't start, amen, trying to act like, give me your phone number. I'm going to text you. Give me your email. You on Facebook? Are we going to connect? No, he said, no, I already told you what you're supposed to drink. Okay, watch this. Watch this. I got to pray. He says, and as you begin to drink of the brook, and I have commanded the ravens to feed thee there. Okay. Why am I? So then where's the ravens going to feed you at? The ravens are only going to feed you at the brook. The ravens are only going to feed you at the brook where the Lord is pouring into you. Are you hearing me? The ravens is not going all over the place. If your spirit is not connected, let me open up this one. If your spirit is not connected to God, and you're not drinking from the wells of salvation, you don't just drink from it and then go somewhere. He said, I want you to dwell there. I want you to hide yourself. You ain't got to worry. You ain't got to go look for nothing. I'm going to command the ravens to come to you. But watch this. They're not going to just come to you anywhere. They're not going to come to you and you murmur and complaining, because that's out of pocket. Where the brook is, there is no murmur and complaining. Are you hearing me? Where the brook is, there is no double-mindedness. Are you hearing me? Where the brook is, there is no doubt. Are you hearing me? Where the brook is, are you hearing me? There is no flesh on operation or on scene. Are you hearing me? He said, I'm going to command the ravens to come to you. You don't have to look for nobody. You just keep your eyes on God and you stay in the place where God has called you. Don't get out of pocket. Don't get out of character. Are you hearing me? I use this as a scenario. Watch this. Keep drinking from the wells of salvation and stay in the place. Stay postured. Stay postured. Don't start. Oh, God, from time. Don't start tripping. Don't start getting upset. Don't start worrying. You cannot get upset. You cannot worry. You cannot murmur. You cannot complain at the brook. No, your spirit has to be in alignment with God. And you got to keep drinking from him. And as you keep drinking from him, he's going to send the ravens to take care of the circumstance. The ravens are commanded to come to you at the brook. Are you hearing me? Your mindset has to be, glory to God. You can't be sitting here acting like, glory to God, well, my mindset right now is on point. Well, somebody made me mad, so now my mindset is, you know, I'm upset now. Well, God said, guess what? The ravens ain't coming. They not coming because you way over here tripping. They not coming because you talking about you crying. They not coming because you over here upset. They're not coming. He said, get yourself where I told you. I told you to hide. Hide yourself. Hey, shoko, manamase. Hide your spirit. Glory to God. Yes, the enemy will try. Yes, he will try to bring you out of pocket. But I told you where to stay. I told you where to go. And eastward, the Bible said when Jesus come back, he's coming back from the east. Are you hearing me? So when he said eastward, he's talking about in the realm of the spirit. Stay in position in the realm of the spirit where I tell you. Don't let none of this, glory to God, natural affliction take you from the brook. Because the ravens are not coming any other place but only to the brook to bless you. So guess what? Y'all get ready to change y'all convo when you're talking to me now. Glory to the Messiah. Because why? In order for the ravens to come, I may have to finish this tonight. How about that? Because I got more and I don't have time to finish it all. Glory to God. So in order for the ravens to come, he said, I commanded. That means I ordered them. Are you hearing me? But you have to be at the place I told you to be in the spirit. Are you hearing me? I commanded the ravens. Watch what he says now. Watch this. The ravens to feed thee there. There. He's telling you where there is. Are you hearing me? He's telling you where there is. Don't let yourself or anybody else or any other unclean spirit to get you out of pocket. Are you hearing me? So you already know the enemy is getting ready to work overtime because he got to get your spirit, come on, out of place. If he can get your spirit out of place, are you hearing me? Then the ravens can't come to that place and bless you. The ravens can't come and feed you. Are you hearing me? Glory to God. Hallelujah. Watch what he says. So he went. So he obeyed. So when we get off of here, you already got instructions from God. Are you hearing me? Come on here. Glory to God. I will be there. All right, all right, all right. That's right. That's right. He said, where I tell you to go is where I'm going to bless you. If you sit here and change the course, if you sit here, glory to God, and divert from the course, if you sit here and you change, you know how it is, we on the street and they got a detour and you want a detour. No, get to where God is telling you to get to. Do what God is telling you to do. Why? Because God is saying that's where the ravens are going to show up. Are you hearing me? That's where the ravens are going to show up. They're going to come to you. They're going to come to you. They're going to find you. Are you hearing me? You don't have to look. Yes, Lord Jesus. You don't have to look for help. Help is on its way. Are you hearing me? Help is on its way. Are you hearing me? Glory to God. You don't have to look for the ravens. That's why he said, hide yourself. Do what I'm telling you to do. Glory to the Lord. Everything you have need of, I'm going to send it to you. I'm going to send you help. But the help is not coming, amen, from a saved person. The help is not coming from a righteous person. The help that is coming from a raven. Is anybody listening? Did everybody go home? Oh my God. Let me tell you something. Let me tell you something. And every time I do say some things, this is years. I was in Arizona at this particular time. I know. We got to pray. And I was in Arizona at this particular time, and God blessed us. We had our building. And when God blessed us and we had our building, well, there was a gang member. He was in gang, and he was not American. He was a different nationality, and God had given me favor with him. He loved my ministry. I can't even talk like him. He has that different like accent, and we was getting the church together, and he came and walked through the door, and he began to talk, and I said, hey, and I, you know, you know, spoke, because I was where God told me to be. And the raven came to me. Are y'all hearing me? The raven came to me. Yes, baby. He was one of the top, amen, drug dealers. He was one of the top gang people. Are you hearing me? Excuse me. That's why you cannot start tripping. Because whom God gonna use, you can't sit here and be tripping. Are you hearing me? Y'all know how I talk. Y'all know how I talk. You know. Y'all been with me for a while. Y'all already know. Please don't get offended because I say, don't be tripping. We always talk like that when we at home. Come on, y'all. Because some people, they start getting offended. Please don't get offended because I'm saying, don't be tripping. Don't trip. Don't trip. Don't start tripping, okay? Glory to God. Please don't get offended with that word. Amen. I respect everybody. Glory to God. And I just believe in teaching and bringing some clarity, insight, understanding. And sometimes you got to teach. You got to come down from all that high teaching. You got to come down so that people can understand it. Y'all understand tripping, don't you? So don't be tripping, okay? That's all it is. Don't be tripping. Vanessa, don't be tripping, girl. I tell myself, girl, don't be tripping. Why are you tripping? You see what I'm saying? So, but if that offended you, I'm sorry. But don't let that offend you because I'm saying that. Are you hearing me? Glory to God. I'm focused on God, precious, but I got to give people understanding. Amen. Because some things offend people and I don't want to offend nobody. Are you hearing me? Glory to God. So if I'm saying you tripping offends you, forgive me. Glory to God. Adabo Shanda. Okay. Okay. So here it is. This man, amen, was one of the top gang leaders. Amen. He was not just gang leader. He sold drugs. Are you hearing me? And I mean, he sold big one. And I was getting a church together and we was in there. We was getting the church together. Glory to God. And all of a sudden he came in. The raven came in. I didn't go looking for no raven. The raven came in. Are you hearing me? And then he began to speak and say, Apostle, in his language. And I began to speak back to him. And he said, what do you need? What do you need? And I said, well, I need, and guess what? He said, I got it. And then he said, let me help you. Let me help you do whatever you need to be done. Amen. To get this church. He didn't go to the church. He didn't go to the church. He didn't lift his hand and say, Lord, I love you. He didn't do none of that. As a matter of fact, when he left, he went back to doing what he was doing before he came. But the raven came. Are you hearing me? The raven came. I didn't have to go looking for the raven. In other words, God said, I told you to be at the church and I told you to do this at this time and I told you to this, that, and the other. And the raven showed up. Are you hearing me? All you got to do is be at the place. God said, be at the place, and I'm going to refresh you, and I'm going to renew you. Do you not know, glory to God, that young man, amen, that was a raven, he blessed my life. Are you hearing me? At that particular season, he blessed my life, even to the point, watch this, that when God, amen, took my husband, amen, that's going on to be with the Lord, amen, him and his wife, yes, he was married, his wife, are you hearing me? Him and his wife, they came in right away and said, what do you need? What do you need? What do you need? Are you hearing me? The raven came to me and said, what do you need? He said, come on here, apostle, in their native language. Come on here. We can take you. We're gonna take you to the furniture store and you tell us what you want. You pick it out. Are you hearing me? My God from Zion. Another, let me tell you another thing that I got to go. Oh yeah, my time is up. I got to bring this back tonight. Glory to God. And I was out of town preaching. Glory to God. And leaders and those that preach, you can get with a sister. You can attest to this. So I go and I'm preaching. And the man of God that was supposed to have my ticket, amen, to come home, he started playing around. Are you hearing me? In other words, playing with the ticket. A buddy pass. I don't need no buddy pass. And at that particular time, I had my two boys and they were smaller and they were with me. Are you hearing me? And so he kept playing. And I said, you know what? I don't have time for this. When the raven heard what was going on with me in a whole different state, glory to God, he told his wife, get her ticket and her sons and get them back here. Are you hearing what I'm saying? Glory to God. I'm not just teaching this and I'm not just praying this because God is just telling me. He's telling me, but if I have experienced it, are you hearing me? Glory to God. And you're going to experience, amen, the ravens are going to feed you. My God, the Bible said that the ravens fed twice a day. The ravens fed in the morning and the ravens came back to feed in the evening. God said, I'm going to command ravens to take care of you, but you have to be what I tell you to be. You have to do what I tell tell you to do. He said, don't be sitting there trying to pass numbers. Don't be sitting there in your mind getting your own thought of what you want from them and what you want to do. Glory to God. Because one thing I do not like when people come into the ministry and other people find out that people got money. Glory to God. I'm saying it because I'm a pastor. So I see it. And I tell a lot of people. I said, don't tell people that you, it's not that they telling, they're getting up and telling the good news of what Jesus is doing. Well, you got people that's in the midst and they listen and they seeing ding, 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 dollar signs. And so instead of connecting with the person because of them and because of being a sister and a brother in the Lord, they connected with them because they got money and they got their own agenda. Are you hearing me? Glory to God. So sometimes you can't sit there and tell somebody, glory to God, in the midst of a whole congregation that you a millionaire. Are you hearing me? That God did it and he gave me the millions of dollars. Because some people, when they, amen, connect with you, they just connecting because they have an agenda. Is anybody listening or did everybody go home? And I would tell people, I would tell them, I said, don't say that. Don't tell people that you got money, because I know some people up in here, they get ready to slither up to you because you got money, because they got their own agenda. And y'all know I told the truth and you know what happened from there. Glory to God. Hallelujah. And so this family that God caused to be a raven in my life at that particular time, because I was doing something for the kingdom of God. I was postured. I was positioned where God had told me. Listen, glory to God. Yes, this was a drug dealer. Yes, this was a leader gang member. Are you hearing me? Yes, God used a raven. Are you hearing me? Yes, I knew their background. Yes, I knew, glory to God, how they lived. Are you hearing me? But I did not watch it. I didn't take down because of how they live. Are you hearing me? I still was being me. Are you hearing me? Glory to God. And they did what they were supposed to do, and then they went on. Are you hearing me? Glory to God. Somebody, glory to God, a raven is coming to your aid. I said ravens are coming to your aid. Ravens are coming to your aid. Now, discernment don't need to be required. Why? Because discernment is to know if that person is of God or not. Are you hearing me? So discernment don't need to be required, because if anybody that's in sin, are you hearing me? They're going to be them. They're going to be them. They're not going to try to hide. Are you hearing me? They're going to be cussers. They're going to be liars. They're going to be fornicators. They're going to be doing all that. They ain't going to try to hide. It's only the church people that ain't doing right going to try to hide. You understand what I'm saying? So discernment at this time is not needed, because God is telling you. What God said, I'm already telling you where you need to be. You need to be positioned where I tell you to be. And when you're positioned where I tell you to be, which is drinking of the water of his spirit, then the ravens have been commanded to come there. Are you hearing me? You don't go look for the ravens. The ravens going to come where you at, in where you postured with God. There is, you're not going to have no worry. You're not going to be worried, beloved. I got to pray now. You're not going to be worrying. Glory to God. God is going to use some ravens. He's going to use some dirty birds. They're going to be unclean. You all don't have to use your discernment. Are you hearing me? They're going to be cussers. You're going to know they're cussers. They're going to be liars. You're going to know they're liars. Are you hearing me? They're going to be fornicators. You know they're fornicators. Come on here. They're going to have the works of the flesh. You gonna know it. Are you hearing me? You don't need no discernment, because they're supposed to come to your aid. Are you hearing me? So you don't need discernment right there. Glory to God. Glory to God. They just gonna be them. They just gonna be them. You know how it is. They just gonna be them. They're going to respect you and give you what it is God told them to help you with. And then you're to let them keep it moving. Like my daughter said, let them keep it moving. Don't sit here and hold a conversation. Don't sit here try to get a picnic. Don't sit here try to get a lunch date. Don't sit here try to get a dinner date. Don't sit here. Are you hearing me? I didn't have to call them. I didn't have to say, would y'all take me out to eat? Listen, God commanded. When God commanded, they always called me. They always showed up. Are you hearing me? And commanded to bless me. Are you hearing me? And God is going to do the same thing for you. I have so much more that I have to bring this tonight. Glory to God. Hallelujah. You got to be at that place. Are you hearing me? Glory to God. The brook is going to maintain one's inner life. Are you hearing me? Glory to God. Hallelujah. You all will not miss a beat. I said, you won't miss a beat. You're going to have need of help. God said, I'm sending help. But the help I'm sending for you is going to come through a raven. I'm going to send ravens now. I'm commanding ravens to help you. I'm commanding ravens to bless you. I'm commanding a dirty bird. They are unclean, said the Lord. That's why you can't connect with them. That's why God said when he took you to the brook of Cherith, Cherith means to cut away. Are you hearing me? That means you to be separated. Are you hearing me? And the birds came, dropped off, and left. You're not to try to, amen, to build a friendship. Are you hearing me? You're not to try, glory to God, to get phone numbers. Are you hearing me? They are to come to help you, and then they are to leave. And as God see fit, he will keep commanding the ravens, that's plural, more than one, to keep coming to help you. In this season, in this time, and in this hour of your life, God is going to use unclean people. Glory to God. They're going to help you. They're going to help you. They're going to help you. Are you hearing me? They're going to help you because God said, I'm going to command you. But the only way they can come to where I have told them to come, you have to be where I tell you to be. Because where I tell you where to be is where you're getting poured in the spirit. Your inner man is being satisfied with God. Is anybody listening or did everybody go home? I'm telling somebody I got to come back tonight and finish it. I'm not even done. I just scratched the surface. Are you hearing me? Glory to God. But because of time's sake, glory to God, I'm coming back tonight and I'm going to finish this one. The ravens are coming. I said the ravens are coming. God said, I'm commanding the ravens to come. God said, prepare yourself. I'm going to tell you somewhere to go. I'm going to tell you something to do. He said, do it like I tell you. Glory to God, say it like I tell you to say it. Why? Because I have commanded ravens to help you. I commanded ravens to bless you. Somebody should be praising God because God said, I'm going to use the unclean people. I'm going, yes, Lord Jesus, I'm going to use a sinner. I'm going to use a sinner to bless you. I'm going to use a sinner to open the door. I'm going to use a sinner to hire you in that position. Glory to God, I'm going to use a sinner, said the Lord. These are dirty birds, they're scavengers. They'll do anything. Are you hearing me? They eat dead carcasses. Are you listening to me? My God, from Zayeba Shikorobo Shanda, he is going to use ravens. Lord, have mercy. Somebody is about to be blessed. And God said it's coming from an unusual place. And it's coming from some dirty birds. Yes, it is. My God, from Zion. I got so many testimonies that will blow your mind. When God said he's going to send ravens, that's just what he means. He's going to command them to come, and they have been commanded to help you. They have been commanded to bless you. They have been commanded, glory to God, to aid you. But God has said you are to be where I tell you to be. You are not to go look for somebody to help you. You are to be and do what I tell you to do and to be what I tell you to be. And when you are there, I'm going to be pouring into your spirit. I'm going to be strengthening you because you got to understand that you read the word of God. It was not a long period of time. This was 3.5 years. It's about 3.5 years that the ravens was taking care of them. So in this season and in this time of your life, God said you just hit the time of your life, the season of your life, that where I have commanded dirty birds. I've commanded the ravens. The ravens are coming. The ravens are coming. The ravens are coming. Are you hearing me? The ravens are coming. But apostle, I can't trust them. You can't trust them to do what? To drop it off? That's all they're supposed to do. What else you got planned? What else you got planned? They're just to drop it off and keep it stepping. So then what you mean you can't trust them? They're unclean. All they're supposed to do is drop off and keep going. You want them to drop off and stay and talk. No, they're going to drop off and keep it moving. Are you hearing me? Are you hearing me? Yes, that's right, precious. You will be where God wants you to be. Amen. They're to just to drop off and keep it moving. You're not to sit there and try to get a friend. You're not to sit there and try to get a buddy. You're not to sit there. Are you hearing me? When you start doing all that, then here come the trust. Are you hearing me? Then you go into the lane, L-A-N-E, of trust. No one said you had to trust them. How you going to trust somebody that's dirty? How you going to trust somebody that don't even live right? How you going to trust them? Because they're going to do whatever it is that they do. Are you hearing me? So they're not supposed to stay with you. They're supposed to come and drop off. They're supposed to come and meet your need. God said, I'm the one that will supply your every need according to the riches and glory by Christ Jesus, right? He said, so me supplying your need, I'm going to use ravens. Ravens are going to supply the need. But God said, it's me, but I'm commanding ravens to supply, to help you. Yet, see, I'm praising God right there. I'm praising God right there. He said, prepare, daughter, wherever I tell you to go, whatever I tell you to do, I'm getting ready to use some ravens to help you. I'm getting ready to use some ravens. I'm getting ready to use some dirty birds. They're going to help you. They're going to help you. Glory to God. They're going to help you. Are you hearing me? Tonight, amen, at 6:30, we're going to go even deeper into this. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Because I understand the time, amen, and where we at and what time it is. Amen. Glory to God. But you need to understand, God has told you and told me, you got to get to the right place. You got to do what I tell you to do. Glory to God. The ravens is not running all over the place. Are you hearing me? You don't have to look for somebody. I'm going to send them to you. But you need to make sure you're in the right place, said the Lord thy God. Hallelujah. Glory to God. And do not forget. Amen. You need to understand. That's right. Come and drop off. Don't sit here and try to befriend them. Don't sit here and talk about let me pray with you. Don't sit here and talk about you need Jesus. They do need Jesus. Glory to God. But that's not the assignment. The assignment is God is sending them to help you. Are you hearing me? The assignment is they are to come to help you. Yes, beloved, they do need Jesus. But here in the text, that's not what it was for at that particular time. But they need me to pray with them. That's not it in the particular time. They're coming in and to drop off. If anybody knows a FedEx truck, glory to God, a UPS truck, or a mail truck, the only thing they're doing is bringing in the mail and they're dropping off, getting in their vehicle, and they're taking off. Are you hearing me? They're not sitting there holding a conversation, coming in into the house, drinking tea and eating crumb cakes with you. They're not doing that. They are dropping off. And then there's sometimes you got to sign. Are you hearing me? For the package. Are you listening to me? But they're dropping off and they're keeping it moving. Are you hearing me? God said, I don't want you to get out of pocket. Do what I'm telling you to do. Glory to God. Shana, separate yourself and I'm going to send them to you, not to you to pray for them, not to you to prophesy to them, not to you, glory to God, to witness to them about Jesus. He said, I'm not going to use them for that right now. I'm using them to bless you. I'm using them to help you. Yes, beloved, you got the answer. The answer is Jesus Christ. Yes, beloved, and let me help you with something. It is not us that is saving anybody. It's God. And if God has not ordained us to speak into somebody's life, glory to God, yes, we can pray for everybody. But God uses who he wants to use to bring that person into the kingdom of God. Your light shall shine that men shall see your good works. Are you hearing me? Glory to God, please don't take this out of pocket. Please don't go to extra mile when you don't have to. God said this season and in this time I'm going to use an unclean bird, glory to God, to help you, and they're going to come and drop up and keep it moving. He said don't try to hold them up, don't try to keep them, amen, for yourself. I'm doing this, said the Lord, because I want to do it. Father God, in the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, by the working power of the Holy Spirit, we thank you for this word. We thank you, Lord God, that you have stopped by, that you have told us where we at, that you told us where we at in this season and at this time. You told us, Lord God, what you're about to do. You told us, Lord God, what we need to do. And so, Father, we pray now that you would give us sensitive ears, that we would hear what the Spirit of the Lord is saying, that we would be at the right place at the right time, that we would be doing what you have called us to do, that you would begin to refresh us, that you would begin to renew us, that you would begin to restore us. And as we are obeying and at the brook, and as we at the place, oh God, the dirty bird, the ravens will come to us, God. We thank you, Lord God, for you have told us what is about to happen. And God, help us to be, Lord God, focused on that you told us to focus on. Help us to stay focused on you, Lord God. Help us, Lord God, not to mingle, my God, with the ravens. Help us, Lord God, not to entwine ourselves with the ravens. God, help us, because the ravens got what it is we need. Glory to God. So God, help us to stay focused. Help us, Lord God, to keep doing what you've called us to do. Even when the ravens come, God, help us. We need your help, Lord God, in the mighty name of Jesus. And Father, I pray for everyone that is on here. And I pray for everyone that will come on after this, oh God. I pray, Lord God, that they will be sensitive to your spirit. I pray, Lord God, that their ears will be open, oh God, and that they will do what you have called them to do, and that they will not get out of pocket, oh God, and that they will not go looking for the ravens, oh God, but the ravens will come to them, oh God, and where they at in you, oh God. Father, I pray, be so my. I pray for every person, oh God. I pray for every family member. I pray for every, my God, relative, in the mighty name of Jesus. I pray for every marriage, oh God, in the name of Jesus. I pray for every leader. I pray for every ministry, in the mighty name of Jesus. I pray, God, that you will do it by your spirit. I pray, God, that you will move by your spirit, in the name of Jesus. Father God, we accept and we receive the word of God. We receive what you are saying, oh God. Help us, Lord God, not to be twixt and in between. Help us, Lord God, not to be double-minded. Help us, Lord God, to be unified with you. Help us, Lord God, to be sensitive. Help us to do what we're supposed to do in this season of our life, oh God. Help us, Lord God, to walk where you told Elijah. Elijah was in that place, oh God, and you commanded the ravens to feed him. My God, in the morning and at night, oh God, you took care of his natural needs, oh God. Glory to God, as he stayed focused and stayed connected. My God, as he began, glory to God, to pray and seek you even the more, God, as he began to talk to you even the more, God. My God, you sent the help. You sent the aid his way, oh God. He didn't have to go looking for it, oh God. You brought it to him, oh God, and the ravens took care of him, oh God. The very people, oh God, that will obey what you're saying for them. My God, the ravens will take care of them, oh God. My God, the phone call will come in, my God, from Zion, and the raven will help them, oh God. We thank you now, Lord God, that it's being done now, God. You are commanding the people right now, God. Those that are unclean, God. Those that are not saved. Those, glory to God, that don't even know you, God. You're using them now, God, in the mighty name of Jesus. And Father, we thank you, Lord God, that we're in alignment with your word. We thank you, Lord God. We thank you that you're doing it for us, oh God. Not because we did something so great. It's because of you, Lord God. And I pray for every person, oh God, that have a need on here. All of us have a need, God, and you've already said you were supplied, God, and you're supplying it through, my God, ravens, oh God, which are unclean. My God, my God, we thank you, Lord, that it is happening now, God. We thank you, Lord, that it's being done now, God, in the mighty name of Jesus. Oh God, we shall obey. We shall do what you tell us to do. We shall go where you tell us to go. And God, we shall hide in you, God. Hide us in you, God. Hide our children in you, God. Hide our marriages in you, God. Hide our finances in you, God. Hide our ministries in you, God. Hide our minds in you, God. In the name of Jesus, let this mind be in me that was also in Christ Jesus. Oh God, we thank you today, Lord, because it is so, God, by your spirit. Oh God, it is done in the mighty name of Jesus. You watch over your word. Your word shall not return back to you void, but it shall accomplish where you sent it. You sent it into our life, God. You sent it to everyone that is connected with me, God. All around the world, God. At such a time as this, God. And we thank you, Lord God, that you have not forgotten about us, oh God. That you heard our cry. That you've heard our prayer, God, and we thank you, Lord God. In advance, we thank you, God, because it is so, Lord God. You're sending a help, God, in the name of Jesus. Oh God, do it, oh God. Those that are sick in their body, God, and they can't get their medicine, you're going to use a raven, God, to bless them with the medicine, oh God. You're going to use a raven, God, to bless them with the foreclosure. You're going to use a raven, God, to bless them with that job opportunity. You're gonna use a raven, God. Oh God, oh God, oh God, oh God, oh God. We thank you that it is so, God. We thank you.
thinking that it is done, oh God. You're going to use a raven to get them in school, God, to get that scholarship, God, in the mighty name of Jesus. My God, that debt will be done and canceled in the name of Jesus. God, we thank you, Lord, that it is so, God, that you're going to use a raven, God. Glory to God, to release the back pay for somebody in the name of Jesus. We thank you, Lord, because it is so, God, because your word said it, and we stand upon your word, because your word cannot fail. Everything going down but the word, in the mighty name of Jesus. And it is so, God, and we thank you, Lord. Oh God, oh God, oh God, oh God. Yes, Lord, send the ravens. Send the ravens. Send the ravens, God. Send the ravens to help, God. Send them now, God, in the name of Jesus. Yes, God, we thank you. Yes, God, we love you. Yes, God, we praise you. We adore you, Lord God, because it is so, God. You're well able to do it, God. Do it by your spirit, and it is so. In the mighty name of Jesus, we decree and declare that it's done, that it's done, that it is so, that it's done. In the name of Jesus, yes, God, yes, God, yes, God. Every person, every person that has come, every person that has joined, every person that have connected, God, on this weather forecast channel, send a raven to their house, send a raven to their job, send a raven to their bank account, send the raven, oh God, to their children's school, send the raven, oh God. Yes, Lord, we thank you for it. Yes, God, we thank you for it. We thank you for it, that you commanded, it's done. You've ordered it, and it is so. And we are in the place. We shall be in the place you called us to be. Every prayer request that is on this page, God, I speak now that a raven go to them now. Every prayer request that is on here now, I hear both. She speak now that a raven go and bless them. A raven go and help them, because you said ravens, more than one. So God, do it. Blow our minds. Show the people that you are God, and beside you there is no other God, in the mighty name of Jesus, and that we are your children, and that you take care of your children, and that we shall want for nothing, in the mighty name of Jesus. And everything that we have need for is already taken care of, and you're going to use a raven, a dirty bird, an unclean person, my God, to bless us, an unclean person to open that door, an unclean person, yes, Lord Jesus, to help us. And we thank you, Lord, because it is so, in Jesus' mighty name. I thank you now, Father. I thank you now, Father. I thank you now, Father, because it is so. It is so, in Jesus' name. It is so. Listen, beloved, this morning, this is the Weather Forecast Channel. The ravens are coming. But tonight, around about 6:30, 6:45, we coming back to finish. I'm not even done. I just tapped the surface. I'm not even done. So we coming back, and we gonna conclude the matter. The ravens are coming. But right now, I'm asking everybody, I'm asking you, everybody, to sow today. Sow on this word. If I was standing before you, ministering to you, everybody that has been to my meetings, nobody leaves out without sowing. Because this word is a sure word from God. You sow on the word, and the word of God is up, so you sow up. Are you hearing me? You're sowing on the word, and you're saying, God, I believe what you said. And so therefore, that reason, I'm going to sow. Now, everyone that is on here and everyone that will come on, I'm looking for you to sow. I'm looking for you to sow. You sow a seed of $100. You sow a seed. Sow your best seed. People have already been sowing. They're sowing on the word. When we got on here this morning, as I was opening up, people were confirming that God was already talking, that God gave people dreams, that people were speaking it out of their mouth. This is the will of God concerning you, concerning me. You and I need to understand, keep your hand open. Keep your hand open. As you keep your hand open, according to the book of Proverbs, as you keep your hand open, God can keep putting stuff in your hand. But when you close it, a closed hand does not get anything in it. See? Nothing can come in it. But if you keep it open, Glory to God. Sow your seed. There's so many people that's on here. So many people around the world. China has even sold in my life. They sold into the ministry. If this ministry is blessing you, the oil of the anointed is blessing you. The Bible said that I'm to sow spiritual unto you, and you're to sow carnal unto me. Your carnal is your money. Are you hearing me? Your carnal is natural things. Are you hearing me? I'm sowing spiritual meat unto you, that your life will never be the same. So you're to sow, amen, the carnal unto me. Are you hearing me? Into the ministry, that we will be able to keep doing what God has called us to do. It takes finances to go all around the world. It takes finances to fly on these planes. It takes finances to stay in hotels. It takes finances, glory to God, to get, amen, the meeting room. Are you hearing me? It takes finances. It takes finances to make sure the needs are met. Are you hearing me? And God has called me to come on here, amen, and to do, amen, what he has called me to do. And I believe that I'm doing to the best of my ability. I'm trying to do it to the best of my ability. Glory to God. And so for that reason, I'm asking everybody, not five people, so everybody. My brother in the gospel, amen, a renowned artist, he said, sis, tell the people to sow. You're on here. You're pouring out. You're giving to the people. Tell the people to sow. Tell the people to sow. Glory to God. What you say, Rob Parsley is preaching about the ravens. I'm done. One of the prophets just told me. They just came on the top of my screen. Rob Parsley. Y'all come on here. Come on here. We're in Ontario preaching, and God is downloading into a major ministry. You're getting the same thing. Lord have mercy. And those that came on earlier and was saying the same thing. Sow your seed. Y'all shall be blowing up my PayPal. Amen. If you're not comfortable with PayPal, then you can mail it. Are you hearing me? If you're in need and you want to get a headband, amen, they're $10 a piece. Amen. Message me. Sow into this oil of the anointing. Amen. We're not begging. We're not trying to make you. I just need you to understand the word is a surety. The word of God is speaking to you. The ravens are coming. Are you hearing me? When I told you about the testimony about the gang leader, I told you about the drug, that man had money. Do you hear me? He had no chump change. He had money. Are you hearing me? He had banks of cash money. Are you hearing me? And because I was at the right place doing what God has called me to do, he sent the raven to bless me. He's going to do the same thing for you. You have heard the word of God. Glory to God. You all that's on here, you joined in with me. You linked with me. You are my sons and my daughters. Especially, you need to be sowing. Everybody on here, you need to be sowing. Sow your seed today. Sow your seed. Glory to God. Sow your seed of $100. Sow your seed. I have people. Let me tell you something. Glory to God. The woman that had the two mites, that was two pennies. That's all she had. She sowed it. Sow your seed. Listen, when I didn't have that, I still sowed. I'm not getting to say, oh God, now look at this. No, I'm saying, oh my God, now God bless them. Triple this. Bless their finances. Bless whatever it is. You got to sow. Amen. I only have, yes, precious, sow it. Sow it. It's the principle. Glory to God. I'm trying to get something to you. Sow your seed. Sow it. Blow that PayPal up today. Because the ravens is coming, boo. Blow it up. Blow that mail up today. You don't want to go PayPal way? Blow the mail up. Sow your seed. And I'm coming back tonight. I just got a message from one of the renowned prophetess. And she just said, Rob Parsley is teaching on the same thing right now. Are y'all hearing me? Before I started, people were letting me know that God was dealing with them. This is the will of God. You need to get in on this. Don't let this word come in. Hallelujah, this Jesus. The raven's going to come. And you didn't even play a part. That's right. Do what you can. We have to sow. Yes, thank you. We have to sow. Yes, sow. Sow. When you go to Walmart and you want that item, you ain't going to go in there and take it. If you take it, you a thief. So now flip the script. If you taking the things of God, the word of God, then you're a thief. And it's not going to amount to anything. Are you hearing me? I'm telling you, if you got $1,000 and God says, sow that, you sow that. And if all you got is a penny, you sow that. This is what I'm trying to get you to understand. You got to start somewhere. I am promising to see that. Amen, precious. You got to start somewhere. This is what I'm telling you. I started somewhere. When I came into the kingdom of God, I didn't know nothing about sowing. Girl, I was taking my money, giving the church a dollar because I needed my money to go out with. But God said, no. And then I'm looking for money and I can't get no money because I didn't understand I was cursed. So I'm not cursed no more. I'm telling you to start somewhere. Start somewhere. Start somewhere. If all you got is a penny, baby, you better do it. And you do it with your head held up. You hear me? And when God start increasing you, then you increase. And you all that can do more, you do more. Don't be trying to size to God. Are you hearing me? Glory to God. I love you. I love you. The ravens are coming. These are unclean people. They're sowing. Bust that PayPal up. Bust it open. Bust it open. Bust it open. I got, when I look at the views, it's over thousands of people. Thousands of people should be sowing. Don't be a thief. Don't try to take the word and run. This is happening all around the world, not because of me, but because of God. I'm not the only one speaking it. People have just told me. I just got a message. It's happening now. Get in on it. Nobody's playing no games with you. This is a principle. We live by the principle, the system of God. Are you hearing me? That's right. Sow your seed today. Blow up PayPal. If you don't trust PayPal, send it in the mail. I have people, Western Union me, from London and China. Oh, come on. Sow your seed on this word. If my ministry been a blessing to you, and my ministry been doing anything positive for you, if it ain't been doing nothing for you, then guess what? Okay. But if it been doing something for you, you better get in on it. You better get in on it. I don't think. What I want to sow big bucks and not to just major people. Are you hearing? Glory to God, into your life. When I step into a city, I bring a seed with me and I sow into somebody in my meetings. I believe in sowing to everybody, not in just leaders. I sow up because I need God to bless me where they are administering. But I also sow to those that are, glory to God, not beneath me. But yet and still, I sow to them because I'm trying to teach the people, not taking from you. I'm coming to give something, not just the word. I'm sowing into people's life. If you have need of a band, we got all types of color. We don't have white. I'm looking for white. Go to my message and tell me. And to you all that have been waiting, the grays have came in. I'm going tomorrow because today is Wednesday. So I'm taking the time Wednesday with ministry. So tomorrow we're going to the mailbox and we are mailing, amen, your headbands. The gray headbands have came in and we are going to release those to you. So if you've been waiting on your headband, your gray ones, they're coming. Amen. Don't forget we even got the t-shirts. Look at y'all looking at me. Message me. Are you hearing me? But right now, sow your seed. Sow your seed. We'll be back tonight, 6:30, 6:45 California time. I'm in California. So you check it out. Listen. Let me turn her off real quick. If you got Bible class, you better go to your Bible class. You better go to your Bible class. Don't you sit there try to come to me and act like I'm saying more than what your pastor is. I ain't saying no more than your pastor. Are you hearing me? Go to your Bible class. Be obedient. Be faithful. Are you hearing me? Are you hearing me? But if you don't have a church home and you don't have Bible class, glory to God, then you are very welcome, amen, to join us tonight. It's supernatural, okay? But do not sit here talking, I'm going to listen to Pastor Jackson when you're supposed to be at the house of God with your man, with your woman of God, okay? Don't do that to them. Don't do that to them and don't do that to me, amen. We are workers. We are co-workers, amen. We are laborers in the gospel, amen. I'm no better than them. They're no better than me, but they cover you. They cover you. I pray with you and pray for you, but they cover you. Okay? Glory to God. So you make sure if you got, amen, Bible class tonight, find your way. Don't forget, if you can't, amen, come on tonight as we are on because of the time, you can pick it back up afterwards, okay? But I just want you to be obedient. I want you to stay in alignment, amen, so God can keep blessing you, okay? I love everybody. I said, blow up the PayPal. Blow it up. Blow it up. I'm sowing spiritual unto you. You sow carnal. Amen. And if you don't care about the PayPal, you don't trust the PayPal. Amen. Then you go ahead and mail it. Amen. All right. All right. And if you want to order, amen, a headband, we have all different colors, all but white. I'm looking for white. Y'all haven't seen me wear white yet. As soon as I get white, I'm going to wear it. Amen. And we have the t-shirts. Look at y'all looking at me. Are you hearing me? So go ahead and message me if you want any of those things. Amen. Also, As I'm concluding the matter, if you want me to come to your ministry, your church, if you're a leader, and if you're a leader and leader position, if you like on a women's ministry, a men's ministry, you understand, if you're a leader, not just a pastor and not just an overseer, but if you're a leader, glory to God, and God has blessed my ministry and you want me to come, amen, to your ministry, you talk to your leader, you talk to your overhead, your overseer, your pastor, amen, and we would love to come as the Lord, amen. I'm old school. I know that's right, girl. Glory to God. And if you want us to come, amen, to your conferences, to your revivals, amen, your workshops, your summits, amen, please, amen, email us, VanessaJacksonMinistries@yahoo.com, amen, because some of you all are over lead, different ministries within the ministry, amen, and so if God is unctioning you for me to come to your church, your house, amen, glory to God, go to your covering and talk to your covering, amen, and then you all email me and we will make that thing happen, amen. Can you post pictures of your t-shirts and headbands on your page so I can share? I sure will, precious. We will make sure we do that. All right. I thank you. That's right. That's right. Look, that's right. Look out for me, girl. Look out for me. I sure will do just that, just for you. Amen. Glory to God. I love y'all. Well, you know, we've been on here long enough. We see the ravens are coming. The unclean people are coming. They're going to bless you. They're not going to be speaking in tongues. They're not going to shabba. They're not coming with no scripture. Are you hearing me? Amen. But they're going to come. Amen. Just to help you. All right. Don't forget. Sow your seed. I love you. Until tonight, if you got your Bible class, you go to your Bible class. If you don't have your Bible class, if you don't have a church home, amen, find yourself. Amen. Let's pick this back up tonight. Until next time, we love you. We love you. We send kisses, hugs, and love all around the world. Amen. You go with God, and God will go with you. Are you hearing me? God will surely go with you. Amen. We love you. Pray for me. You know I got you. Talk to you later. Blessings.